Hi everybody, welcome. This is episode 62. I am Mike Martin. With me is our fine wine buyer, John Fanning, as usual. And today we have a big, lush California Chardonnay by the Antinori family. It's called Antica. And this is the 2010 vintage. It was rated 93 points by the Wine Advocate.
Selling $26?
Yeah, $25.99. It actually dropped 1 point from the Wine Advocate from last vintage, but I actually prefer this vintage. It's a little lighter and a little cleaner, I think, than the previous vintage. But 93 is a healthy score for a big lush Chardonnay.
Yeah. So Antica is a, I think you said this, has a combination of the family name Antinori and the word California, the name California. And currently Piero Antinori runs the Antinori business, 26th generation to be running the Antinori wine brand, started in Florence, Italy, you know, originally Tuscan.
Yeah, because we have a lot of their Italian wine.
Absolutely, yeah. Yeah, pretty, you know, benchmark in Italian wine. Mm-hmm. Story goes that he visited Napa way back in 1966, really fell in love with it, fell in love with all its potential, and you know, with as much going on as he has, took him 40 years plus to really get back and start his own winery. And yeah, 10 years ago or so, started Antica up in Atlas Peak, mm-hmm. which, if I understand correctly, is kind of southeastern part of Napa, mm-hmm. a little bit inland.
Yeah, this is one of the first whites they've made. I think I was reading that maybe second or third vintage. Everything else was red. I think we might have even done a red earlier.
We also have the Cabernet Sauvignon in the store.
Yeah, I think I did. I think I might have done that. But yeah, this is. It doesn't have a real golden color like I would have thought from California. You definitely get the oak, but I think it's very, very balanced in this wine. Oak lovers will love it, but it's lush. I mean, it's just
lush,
like, a lot of tropical fruit. Get a pear, apple, good minerality.
Good minerality, which saves it from having too much oak.
Yeah.
Very typical and really delicious example of just full-blown Napa Valley Chardonnay. I mean,
yeah.
This is the style that California really made their name on, mm-hmm. as far as Chardonnay goes. And, you know, often, even for oak lovers, the wood and the oak nuances can just be too much.
Yeah.
This is a really great balance of all.
Yeah, I don't think it would overpower things. I mean, this would be great with like lobster and butter and very rich, maybe rich seafoods and creamy sauces and things like that. But
absolutely.
You were saying that this is the type of wine that you like to drink when you're in California.
Yeah, yeah. This one, I don't often drink wines this big, this rich.
Yeah.
I think when you're in Napa Valley, just it goes with the territory.
Yeah, and the foods there probably
absolutely.
Too. Yeah, absolutely.
Very conducive.
Good, very good. Well, okay. Well, so glad we could show this wine to you. It's expensive, but you know, I think it's worth it. It's very delicious.
It's expensive.
It's
I mean, California Chardonnay is expensive.
Yeah,
I think $26 for a 93-point Napa Chard,
yeah.
You know, with this pedigree, it's actually a pretty good price for
yeah.
wine.
No, it's delicious. Okay. Well, thanks very much, and we'll see you next week.